This is the sixth video in a tutorial series where we make this animation with a Blender Python script. Hi, I'm Victor Stepanov. It's great that you made it to part 6. Let's dive in. In this part, we'll be iterating through the steps of creating a material with Python. We'll start off with a blank slate, add all the nodes we need, align the nodes we've added, set up the connections, and finally populate the color ramp from our palette. As always, let's go to the drawing board to create our mental model of what we're aiming at. In the previous video, we created a stack of curves. Let's collapse that into a compact form. We'll start off by adding a function that will create the material. We'll go into Generate Perlin Curve to assign the material we just created. Let's make some room for the contents of the Create Material function. The next step will be removing all the nodes to make it easier for us to start iterating. We'll add the texture coordinate node and the rest of the nodes we need. We will move all the nodes into place and set up the connections. Finally, we'll apply the colors from our color palette. Make sure to keep this big picture in mind as we edit the script. As always, you can find the code we'll be starting off with on the GitHub page for this series. Look for Start Code in the description. I'll add the code that we'll have at the end of this video right underneath that. To start working on our material, we'll first need to change our scripting workspace to have the shader editor so we can see the resulting material as we iterate. We don't need the timeline anymore, so we're gonna just change it to the shader editor. I'm gonna collapse this. And hovering over the 3D viewport, I'm gonna press Z and then select material preview so we can see the resulting material. Before writing the script that creates the material, let's first start off by creating the material by hand so we'll know where we're going. I'm gonna go into the shader editor and click new, and let's just zoom in right here. We have the material output in the principal BSDF. I'm gonna add a color ramp by hitting Shift A and then searching for a color ramp, just placing it right here and connecting the color to the base color. Next, we'll need a gradient texture. I'm going to place it right here, connect the color to the FAC, and we'll need a mapping node right here, connect the vector to the vector, and the texture coordinate, and we'll connect the object to the vector right here. Let's create some colors in the color ramp. I'm just going to change these so it'll be more visible. All right, you can see it's only at the top. We'll need to rotate this 90 degrees and scale on the Z axis by 0.1. Now I'm going to select all the other curves by hitting Shift and then dragging and selecting the rest of the objects, and then hitting Control L and then link material. I'm going to deselect that, and now you can see that we have a material going on here. It's not going to be the final material, of course, but this is just to show you what we're going to be doing with Python. Before we start iterating on our material, we're going to need to know the names of the types of each node. The fastest way to do that right now is go into the interactive Python console and loop over the nodes of this current material. Let's see what is going on here. So I created a loop that looks at the current material. This material, it's called just material right here. You can see the same name. And it looks into the node tree and gets the nodes and loops over every single one of them. It assigns each node into this node variable, and then it prints out the name with a nice formatting. So it reserves like 20 characters. So it's like, it's nice and aligned, and then it prints out the type. So this is right here, the type. We'll need this in just a minute when we'll be creating each node. I'm just gonna select this right here, hit Control C to copy, and I'll start creating our function that will create the material. You can comment multiple lines by hitting control forward slash and then hitting tab again to indent everything. To create a material in Python, we'll first need to create the material, remove all the nodes so we have a blank slate, then add the nodes that we need, and finally connect all the nodes. Let me write down all these in comments and we'll fill in the blanks as we go. Now let's start filling in the blanks by creating a material, enabling nodes, and setting this new material to all the curves that we're creating in a loop. We're just going to create a new entry in the context dictionary called material and assign this new material to that. And then we're going to use that inside of the loop. Now let's assign this material to our curves. So now we've assigned the material that we just created to each curve object that we created in a loop. And also we're just gonna enable shade flat. Now let's run it and see what happens. Now let's look at the material that was created. As you can see, it's just a principal BSDF and the material output. Let's start iterating on our material. Let's go back where we're creating our material and start adding the code that removes all the nodes from the material so we can have a blank slate. Now let's run that. Now, as you can see, the object has turned to pink, and that's because we don't have any material output. Let's fix that. As you can see, I used the type that we saved at the beginning and used it right here to create a new material node. So let's run this and see what happens. Now, as you can see, we have a single material output. Let's go and add the rest of these nodes. I went ahead and just typed the rest of the material node creation code out for you, so you don't have to watch me type. I just added the texture coordinate with the texture type, the mapping, the gradient texture, the color ramp, and the principal BSDF. Nothing really changed, it's just I'm running the create new material node and then just assigning the results into a variable. Let's run that and see what happens. As you can see in the shader editor, all the nodes that we want were added, but there's a problem, they're not connected and they get placed right into the middle of the shader editor. So let's fix that. Let's create a variable to track the X coordinate of all these nodes, and we'll add a value to it to offset every node as we add them. So this is how it's gonna look. We're gonna create a variable, and then we're gonna modify the location of the node by using this variable and then add a value to offset. Let's see how this looks. As you can see, so we have the texture coordinate right here. It starts with 0. Then we have the mapping, next one, and then I'll update the rest. Okay, I finished updating all the nodes. I gave some extra breathing room for the color ramp and the principal BSDF with that material output. So let's run it and see how it looks. Right, here is how it looks, and they're all aligned. That's good. Now let's connect them. Let's set up our first link between the principal BSDF node and the material output. So right here, these two nodes, let's connect them with Python. Now let's run that and see what happens. You can see the principal BSDF and the material output are now connected. And if I start modifying the base color right here, just watch the viewport as I play around with the color wheel. And now we have that connected. That's great. Let's connect the rest of them. I've set up the rest of the links. As you can see, the color of the color ramp right here goes in the base color of the principal BSDF. The mapping node vector output right here goes into the vector output of the gradient texture. Then we have the texture coordinates, the object right here going into the vector of the mapping. And then we have the gradient texture, the color output going into the color ramp back. Now let's run it and see. All right, now they're all connected. And as you can see, there's some kind of gradient going on here. To make the material look as we wanted, we'll need to modify the mapping node and rotate by 90 and then scale on the z-axis by 0.1. Let's do that. Now you can see we are getting the result that we want, but the color is not there yet. We'll fix that in a minute. As you can see, we use the inputs right here, the rotation, exact name right here, and the scale. And we're setting the default value. So if there isn't any incoming link, the default is going to be 90 degrees. We have to turn this into radians because that's what the underlying Blender data requires. And then we have the scale, the default value of the scale on the Z axis we're setting to 0.1. Now let's add the color. So we're going to scroll all the way down right before the loop in the gen scene function. And we're going to call the function that's going to help us create a color ramp with a number of colors that we've selected. Now let's run this. As you can see, the color ramp has our colors that are in our context dictionary right here. We set up these colors in the helper code above. I'm not gonna go into detail in this video, it's getting long. Similar to this make color ramp from colors, I'll dive into that in a separate video. And as you can see, we're getting our material, getting the nodes, and then passing the colors and the color ramp into this function that helps us create this color ramp. Now let's group this setup material code into a function. I'm gonna go right after the material creation code. Since we're using context here, we need to pass it in. And now let's call this from right here. And then let's run it. And as you can see, it still works. Congratulations making it this far. Make sure to save your work. If you had any questions during the video, make sure to ask them in the comments. In the next video, we'll be setting up a HDRI to light up the scene. Subscribe to not miss it.